Good morning and welcome to the National Basketball Arena. We're just about to get underway in the first of the school's league finals. This one's an under-16B boys final between Pipers Hill from Naas and Colosta Pobl Setanta. Just waiting for the tip-off here. I'm joined for this one by under-18 Ireland men's head coach Conor James. Conor, morning to you.
Morning, man.
So we've seen Setanta already lift the cup as the ball is about to go up. What kind of game can we expect today in the boys' B final?
Yeah, there's a lot of talented players that are recognised out there. Colosta Pobl Setanta have a good bit of firepower. I think Pirates have some good players. Colosta Pobl Setanta are a bit deeper, so it'll be about how tired the Pirates Hill players get and can Colosta Pobl Setanta wear them down.
So Kucevic with the ball for Setanta. Takes the first shot of the game, can't make it. And Pipers Hill, who we've not seen in the arena so far this season, have the ball with Alex Duro. Kane open from the three-point line. Kane takes an early three, doesn't get it. And the rebound can't be secured by Fajani, but it is in back into the hands of Kucevic. Kucevic, long two, and Kucevic nails the first score of the game.
Yeah, great effort by Kucevic, and you gotta think that Pipers Hill will have to stop those shots, because even if they don't go in, Sami Fajana is 6'7", and he's gonna clean up on the boards.
Kane trying to find someone in space. He does eventually find Ben Kelly, and Kelly steps out of bounds. So he'll be out of bounds, and animated Keith Maguire, coach of Pipers Hill, calls an early timeout. So an early 2-0 lead for Setanta, and a bit of full court pressure out of the timeout there, Conor.
Yeah, it's better. Like, I mean, the guards haven't shown particularly amazing dribbling skills, and if they can pressure them early, it's going to stop them getting those easy shots, and again, stop them getting the ball into Big Sammy inside.
And we see a bit of full court pressure from Setanta as well. So both coaches doing a good bit of coaching during the timeout, as Kane gets it into the hands of Maguire. Maguire, fadeaway jump shot, bounces out. And that man you talk about, Fajani, was MVP in the cup final. Grabs his first rebound of the game. Nice pass inside from Fajani, but Shea can't finish.
Yeah, great pass, unfortunately not to get the roll on the rim.
There we see the height of Fajani as he blocks the shot from Maguire, but it will remain Pipers Hill ball and into the hands of Duro. Kane grabs the offensive rebound, back out to Duro again. Long three, bounces away, from Maguire, and it's Pajani showing his ball handling skills as he looks to get all the way to Hope with a beautiful finish down the lane.
Rare enough that you'll find someone who's 6'7", 15 years old that can do that, but he's an international player for a reason, and he can take that skill with him over to Europeans, he'll do some damage.
Great finish, long three from Maguire. Doesn't go, but trying to find his range early. I'm sure he will eventually. A nice pass inside. Great finish and the first basket of the game for Ben Kelly as Piper's Hill on the scoreboard.
You just see Kloschenhoff's Satanta set up in a box and one there. They're really trying to take Jack McGuire out of the game. Suppose if they can limit him to just shooting those long three-pointers, they'll be happy with that. And just try and take him out of the game as much as possible.
Long three from Kucevic doesn't go, but it's put back in on the rebound from Kevin Shea. And it's 6-2 to Satanta. Maguire gets the ball to the wing and Kane, but Kane's nowhere to go for Gianni. Maguire takes another three, and this time Maguire has found his range. And a couple of early misses, but always looked like he would make one eventually.
Shooters have to shoot, and his boxer one defender just turned his head. He rolled right to the corner, and lovely arc of the shot.
Pajani gets the basket and is fouled, so he'll go to the free throw line for one bonus shot.
Yeah, he's a big boy. You've got to stop him getting the ball that deep, because once you do, it's either going to be a foul or a score, and unfortunately this time it's both.
So 9-5, early Santa Maguire. Back to duo. Into hands of Maguire, who's been the offensive power so far, Piper's Hill, but missed that one. But great rebound inside, and another basket for Ben Kelly.
Yeah, Ben Kelly doing some good work inside. Maguire just threw over for Jana for the block, which leaves the left side open for the weak for the rebound. And Kelly came up with a rebound and a score.
And Miloš Kucevic gets another basket for Satanta. He's off to a fast start as well. That's Maguire down the middle of the lane to that man, Kelly. Kelly can't make this one, and it's Pajani on the break. They'll need to stop him early. They don't. And he gets all the way to the basket and finishes for another two.
Yeah, you just got to foul him at the halfway line there. Take the hit for the team. You've only got one team foul. There's only 3:20 left. Take the foul, set up your defense, and try and stop him from there.
Maguire closely guarded by Kucevic, but too closely guarded, and it would be a foul. So 13-7 to Kolašta Pobl Satanta, Piper's Hill, but here, shot from Kane bounces off, and it'll be a violation.
Unfortunate there from Kelly. I think his head knew what he was doing before his body knew.
Here's Pajani. Good defense this time as three people get in for a trap, and here comes Maguire. Floater on the break, doesn't go, and rebounded by Thornton. Thornton down the middle lane, and lovely finish off the glass for two from Thornton.
Yeah, Piper's Hill won't be happy though. That's at least six fast break points they've given up now, and hardly end them in their own half by the time the ball was laid up.
Daniel Kane banks a two, and we're 15-9 with 2:30 to go. Again, a bit of pressure from Piper's Hill, but a foul called. That one again against Jack Hogan. It's his first. Long three from Kucevic. Kane finds Maguire. Maguire for another three from the corner. doesn't go. And another quick foul there, but that'll be the third. And Connor, the shooting of Maguire is going to play a big part in this game, obviously.
Yeah, look, the harder he has to work for the shots, you know, the higher the chance of it not going in. So if Koshful Satana keep making him work that hard, it's going to be very tough for him later on in the game. They just need a key in on him, because when he is open, he will knock them down.
Inside, Johnny, nice pass inside, down the middle of the lane. Kucevic can't make that one. And rebounded by Kane. Kane finds Maguire. Again, good defense. Can't get the shot off. Kelly doesn't make the short jump shot, and rebounded by Kevin Shea. Good defense on Maguire. Gets a turnover.
Yeah, he did well there. Just closed off the lane. Nowhere to go. And a bit unfortunate that it came off his own shoe, but Piper will be happy with that one.
So still a tight game. 6-point game. 1:24 to go. Shea might have got away with the travel. In fact, it's not Shea, sorry, Jack Hogan. Maguire looking for a little bit of space. Straight into Kucevic. Takes a tough fadeaway shot, and it's rebounded by Thornton.
Yeah, and they're the shots that Clashwell Satanta will be trying to make him shoot. You know, really tough over a big guy. They're really liking just sticking Sammy Fajana right in the middle of the key there. So anything that goes near him, he's going to clean up. If the shots don't start falling, then it's going to be tough for him to find a way into this game.
Alex Jones, some silky dribbling, finds a bit of space but can't finish. Rebounded by Fajani, goes through the legs of Kane as the crowd like a bit of two tricks. And in the end, it's Kevin Shea shoots a three, doesn't make it, but rebounded by Adelaney. And eventually it comes into the hands of Ben Kelly before a foul is called. And that'll be Satanta's third team foul. So it'll be sideline ball again. 38 seconds to go, 15-9 to Kolosh the Pobl Satanta. And Daniel Kane is called for a travel in the open court. Can ill afford to turn the ball over that easily?
Yeah, and that's just what happens when there's a box to one defense. They're trying to get the ball to Maguire, but he's being closely guarded. And sometimes those sort of silly mistakes just happen.
Thornton for three. Doesn't go, rebounded by Adelani, and he finds Kucevic. 20 seconds to go in the first quarter. Fajani with the ball, closely guarded by Maguire. Finds Thornton on the opposite wing. Thornton bounces in and out, and 11 seconds to go. They'll get the ball into the hands of Maguire. He'll have a chance for one last shot here. If he can find a bit of space, Maguire, deep three. And bounces in and out, but Adeo gets the rebound, but he can't finish. So at the end of the first quarter, the end of 16 boys final, it's Kolosh the Pobl Satanta 15, Pipers Hill 9. So welcome back. Just to start the second quarter, the under-16B Schools League Final. A nice basket inside early from Jack Hogan. He cuts the lead to 4 points.
Yeah, great layup by Jack. Just got deep in the key, and Sammy wasn't there this time, so no one to stop him. And got the layup, but unfortunately Sammy comes right back down and answers one or two of his own.
So Maguire looks to set things up to Adiero. Kelly looking for a bit of space. Three for Maguire. And Maguire makes that one a tough three. Looked good for the minute, left his hand.
A nice fist pump to go with it. Although I suppose when you're working so hard to get them, when they go in, you're delighted.
Inside for Shea. Can't make it. Good rebound from Kelly. Looking for the outlet pass. Good defense from Shea. Slows it down a little bit. Hogan manages to get it to Maguire, but as always, Maguire has close attention, being guarded tightly by Jimmy Rotary, who's checked into the game for Satanta. But Kelly down the middle lane with a floater. Doesn't go. Rebound for Jani. Gets it in the hands of Kucevic. Kucevic, nice hesitation, gets the basket. And Shea finishes for two.
A great finish from a very tough angle. Just got the friendly roll on the rim.
Maguire looking for the screen. Decides against the three this time. Gets it into the hands of Adair, who finds a little bit of space. Finds Maguire in the corner for three. Bounces out, but good rebound from Hogan. Gets it back out to Adero, and he makes it two. And again, cuts the lead. Back to a three-point game. Good defense from Typus Hill as they converge on the ball and get it tipped out of bounds. Into the game for the first time comes number 15, Josh Dunn, and he'll give Jack Hogan a quick rest. Kucevic to Thornton, Kucevic to Vajani. But that hat pass from his teammate just misses him there, and Thornton finds Vajani on the three-point line, who will shoot it. Doesn't go, and Adair is off to the races. And he makes no mistake. And it's a one-point game with 5:30 to go in this second quarter. And again, a bit of full-court pressure.
It's a lot smarter from Piper's Hill. Keeping Fajana out of the three-point line, and on the other end working hard, and they eventually get the easy basket. And they haven't had too many easy baskets all game.
And Fajani is called for a travel, and Piper's Hill first chance since the opening tip to take the lead. Kelly on the three-point line gets great fake there from Kelly, gets Vajani off the floor and goes up and underneath him for two, and it is Piper's Hill who take the lead 20-19.
That was a super finish by Kelly. Did really well at the pump fake to get Vajani up in the air, and that's what they need to do, start attacking and maybe get him in foul trouble, and once that happens there's a lot of space, the key will open up.
And a nice move from Vajani to answer that, and Maguire comes down the lane, doesn't get it, rebound from Kane, but good hands and nice bit of skill there from Kevin Shea. And he'll find Thornton on the break. Thornton can't finish, and it's into the hands of Kelly as the game picks up pace. Maguire looks for a bit of space. A tough shot from Maguire. So he's bumped on the way in.
Yeah, Klosh rolls the time. He won't be too happy with that now. He's very easy into lane. In fairness, it was a very tough finish, but he's good enough to make those shots, and you've got to stop him from getting in the lane in the first place.
Kevin Shea can't finish, and he can turns that mistake by fouling, and we'll have a couple of subs for Klosh Republic-Satanta as they look to get a bit of rest. It's Keane Thornton will go up, and into the game comes Josh Timog, and also it's going to be Richard Grigoris. As Piper's Hill thought of the timeout, but it isn't, so they'll have to come back onto the court. Just over the last few minutes, starting to see a little bit more of the other players from Pipers Hill, and is that the difference that's got them back into this game?
Yeah, you can see all the players stepping up, and it's too much of to ask of one man to beat a team full of good players, and it's great to see a couple of guys step up, and not just step up by making shots, but making good decisions and good basketball plays.
Daniel Kane very nearly makes that three. And just steps on the line there in his first action. Richard Gregoris just getting used to the size of the court. And again, full court pressure from Setanta. Maguire caught in the trap, needs to find a pass. Just gets over the halfway line in time. Much to the frustration of Slajan Kucevic, the coach of Setanta. 3:25 to go. Gregoris this time keeps himself inside the boundaries. But the defense from Pipers Hill is giving nothing inside to Setanta. They eventually get to Shea, and good defense on Fajani this time, but it will remain Satanta's ball. And we'll have a timeout called with 3:07 to go. It's Pipers Hill leading 22-21. So welcome back, 1-point game here. Fajani retakes the lead for Setanta. And Connor, during the timeout there, Pipers Hill very much back into the game. What the two coaches have been talking about, and who will be the happier of the two there?
Yeah, I think Pipers Hill, given the slow start they had, will be happier of the two. They started making shots that weren't going in the first 5 minutes of the game. He won't be too happy after that. It was simple inbounds play, and just a 1-2 and one given away. And there's no point in really trying to block Fajan at the rim, because it's going to take too much to stop him. But overall, I think Pirates will be very happy given the slow start they had, and given, like you said, everyone's stepping up now.
So Kane can't make that float up. Good defense from Maguire. Bobbles the ball loose, but it's back into the hands of Fajani, and he just asks Timog to come back. Get the ball, floats one inside, and finds Fajani. Nice move from Fajani, and he has another two. It's 25-22, and the full court pressure comes on. Just get it into Maguire, but he runs straight in to the defense of Gregoris, but gets his way through it. Kane decides not to take the shot this time, but gets it in the hands of Alex Duro, and tough three for Maguire. Doesn't make that one.
Yeah, I think Pipers Hill just need to really keep their zone compact. They don't need to play the guard so high, because they haven't really made any outside shots. Everything they've done has come from the inside. Just keep the key nice and clogged up, and goad them into shooting. And if they make them, they make them. If they don't, then you've left yourself at least with a bit of a chance.
Lovely pass to Maguire on the break. And Alex Duro gets another basket for himself. And it's 25-24, Setanta.
Yeah, great work from Maguire there. Drew all the defenders and left his teammate with the easy bucket.
Foul called against Kane. Going to be two shots to Fajani. Actually, it's gone against Ben Kelly, the foul.
Fajani's really shown a nice touch around the rim. He hasn't missed too many once he's got there. You know, he's a bit of a silky finisher, and I think Piper's Hill just need to get one man in front, one man behind. You know, any lob passes, the help defense can come collect. But it's too easy at the moment for him.
It's two shots, not one. The referee also corrected his call there, went back. It was number five. The foul was on. So Ben Kane picks up his first. That's right, looks to Daniel Kane. Excuse me. So it's a two-point game here. You see the full court pressure here, and it is into the hands of Daniel Kane. Maguire. First open shot on the baseline, and off the races goes Josh Timog. A nice little fake and a fadeaway jump shot from Timog, and he salutes the crowd as he runs back.
Super move. I'm not too sure of any Super League players that might even be able to do that.
Three for Maguire, bounced off, but into the hands of Dunn. And a steal here from Satanta, and it's Kevin Shea, but throws it straight to the hands of Ben Kelly, who finds Maguire. Maguire this time fakes the three, gets the foul line. Nice floater, doesn't get the roll, and rebounded by Sami Fajani.
You can see Maguire just getting a little bit frustrated that, you know, the shots aren't dropping, and it's really down to that caution pull to down the defense. They're just making him work very, very hard.
Huge three from Kevin Shea right at the end of the second quarter. Extends the lead to 7 points. Maguire tries to close it down, can't do it. 15 seconds to go in the court, and Fajani will have a chance to give himself a big lead, and he does as he makes a two, and he's fouled. And all of a sudden, from a two-point game or three-point game, it's now a nine-point game with a chance to make it 10 with 11 seconds to go.
Yeah, coach of Piper's Hill won't be too happy with this sequence of events that just happened. I mean, they had 24 seconds left on the clock, should have ran it out. Maguire probably took a bad option and resulted in a three-point play down the other end. Fajana's really the one doing all the damage. You stop him, you stop the team. So at half-time, they'll just want to find a way to stop him.
So Maguire will have one chance to redeem himself. Nearly does, but good defense from Shea. Just knocks out of the hands of Kane. And it's 6.4 seconds on the clock. They'll have one last chance to get a score, but they're stolen by Shea. And he's going to get a shot from the halfway line. He does. It's not far off. It bounces in and out. So at the end of the first half, at the under-16B boys final, it's Kolostopoulos Satanta 34, Piper's Hill Nace 24. Welcome back here, start the second half of the under 16B boys schools league final. It's Colosta Pobl Setanta leading by 10, and Connor, close game for the entire first half, but just at the end Pipers fell asleep a little bit. What will they do to try and get back in this game in this second half?
It's very simple. They just got to stop the one guy, stop Sami Kajana, find a way, and start getting out in the break, start getting some easy baskets. I mean, Fajana seems to be getting the ball a bit too easy inside, and like I said, he's 6'7", he's strong, he's got to finish over guys. So stop him getting the ball, put a bit more pressure on the pass, and then try to get out in the break, get some easy baskets, and, you know, Pipers Hill at this point have nothing to lose, just put them under a bit of pressure.
And call out of bounds there. I think they had a slightly better position than the referees. He most certainly wasn't. But good hand from Kevin Shea. And you see Connor Thornton paying close attention to Maguire. But inside to Ajua, but good block from Fajani, and it's into the hands of Thornton. Inside of Gianni, can't get it, and Ben Kelly has a chance to start the break, and he finds Kane. Kane back out to Maguire. Maguire, Thornton, give him nowhere to go here. Takes a nice fadeaway jump shot, doesn't go, but Joe gets the rebound, floats it up, bounces in and out, and Kucevic draws a foul on Kane.
Yeah, very lucky not to get the roll. Nice turnaround from Maguire. Again, unlucky the shot, and certainly unlucky with the rebound. But you know, that's what they got to start doing. Start looking for those easy shots. Stop taking so many, you know, deep trees, and just go up against Big Sammy. Take it to him. Try to get him in some foul trouble.
That's the third foul on Daniel Kane, as Pajani does take a deep three, and he makes that one. And you mentioned them trying to leave him open when he hits them. I suppose they're really damned if they do and damned if they don't.
Yeah, if he starts making them, they're in trouble. But I think they'd be a bit happier with leaving him out there and shooting than picking up 3 points the old-fashioned way inside.
Yeah, he's proved impossible to stop inside as Kane tries to find a bit of space. Maguire with a bit of space this time. But good defense from Setanta. But Gianni, then Thornton, not giving Maguire any space. And Juro can't find space inside. Juro, sorry. And there is Ben Kelly, and he'll inadvertently find Hogan. And a travel there, and notably, Connor, the defense has really picked up in this second half from Setanta.
Well, that's it. Clash of Pobl Setanta are doing exactly what Pipers Hill should be doing. They're completely keying in on their best player and Jack Maguire, and not letting him get anything easy. He's taking some really tough shots. And then the other end, you know, Sammy's probably getting something a bit too easy.
Thornton winds his way through the middle, but can't finish, and here is Jack Maguire, but Thornton wastes no time in getting right back into his pocket, and Duro can't find it, and the defence of Connor Thornton has really upped the level of Colosta Pobl Setanta as they've extended their lead to 13 here, and their big crowd starts to get behind him. Long three from Maguire, that one just bounces out, and they need some of those to go. Inside to Pajani, pass out to Timog. Timog can't make it, but rebound Kucevic, and blocked, but a foul's called on Kane, and that's going to be his fourth.
Yeah, they just allow him to pass into Pajani so easy inside. He gets the ball, and then he's surrounded, and then he can kick out for shooters, and the shooters are wide open. Eventually, they're going to start making them. Just deny the ball into Pajani to begin with. Make the other guys step up.
Kucevic can't make the first, and interestingly enough, Daniel Kane stays in the game on four fouls, which perhaps shows that Keith Maguire, coach in Pipers Hill, doesn't have too many options on his bench. Maguire blocked by Fajani. Kelly down the middle, and Kelly gets a roll. And back to 12.
Yeah, great floater by Kelly. Maguire unlucky with a super block by Fajana initially, and played it well, secured the rebound and get it back up over Fajana.
Thornton, nice fake, jump shot doesn't go, and rebound into the hands from Hogan, and he gets it to Maguire. Again, closely guarded by Thornton, with help around him as well. He gets around him this time, but goes straight into three players. Nice pass outside to Kelly, who can't make it, and travel call.
Yeah, Thornton's being quite smart. He's really playing Maguire up high, so they've really just taken away the three-pointer and forced him to go past him inside, to exactly where Sammy Fajana's going to be to block the shot.
Yeah, and after a conversation with the son, Coach Keith Maguire calls a timeout, try and talk it over and see if they can get a little bit more space. Back with you shortly. So welcome back. 4-4 to go in this third quarter, then the 16B boys final. It's Colostra Pobl Setanta leading Pipers Hill from Nace, 38-26. And Connor, with a timeout from Pipers Hill, will it be talking about different ways to try and get Maguire open?
Yeah, I think so. But also, right on cue, just get other guys to step up. I mean, if the ball's not going for Maguire, they need other options as well. And the guys have shown already thus far that they're more than capable of scoring the ball.
And Duo does exactly that as the Pipers Hill crowd start to get behind their team. And a good play out of the timeout there for Pipers Hill, as they do exactly as Connor suggests. Find a little bit of space for someone else to score. And it's only a 10-point game, plenty of time to go in this one.
Yeah, I think if they can get it back to six or five before the end of the quarter, they'll be happy.
And Connor Thornton stops that from happening too quickly. And here comes Jack Maguire, who's guarded by a mixture of Thornton and Kucevic. High screen again, same play as last time, and same players inside, and a great finish. And a good timeout from Pipers Hill results in back-to-back baskets.
Yeah, and both from inside the key, working tough, taking Sammy a bit away from the basket, hitting the roller, and again finishing with the easy two.
Kucevic, nice pass outside, long two from Gregors, doesn't go, and eventually it's Pipers Hill ball, and a chance to cut this to single figures. Maguire, slowed down by Gregorius, but back to Thornton. Again, same play. Maguire this time, deep three, bounces in and out.
it's easy to be tempted by those sort of shots when you're down 10, but you've just got to stick to what's working, and that's getting the ball inside so far.
Thornton looks to find a bit of penetration in the key. Finds Bajani for three. He made his last. We'll take another one. Doesn't go, and a good rebound by Gagoas. Good hands inside from Kane, but again, Kevin Shea was quietly having himself a really good game for Setanta, but they can't stop that man, Bajani.
Yeah, good working move by Shea, and then another finish by a man who's probably not so quietly having a good game.
And Jack Maguire just frustrated that he can't make that little bit of touch off the glass there. So 1:44 to go in the third. Setanta leading 42-30 over Piper's Hill. Johnny across to Kucevic. Kucevic for three, doesn't go. Rebounded by Kelly. And Kelly will bring it up himself. Now it'll be Kane back to Kelly. Can't get a shot up, but Kane does get a three off. Bounces in and out, and Pajani cleans up the boards. Good defense this time from Piper's Hill, and eventually Kelly grabs the ball and into Duro. He's a two on one, but goes at Pajani. Not a wise choice.
Johnny, he's very disciplined when people come in the key against him. He knows when to jump, when not to jump. He knows he's bigger. He can stay on his feet for longer.
A great finish from Connor Thornton. Extends the lead to 14 here with 35 to go. Maguire, nice little hesitation, but can't find the inside pass, but will come off for Johnny's feet, and it will be end line ball as Kevin Shea has a rest, and Jimmy Rotary comes back in. Duo to Kelly. Kelly, a nice ball fake. And a nice shot from Kelly. He's found the score and touch a little bit in the second half. So 18 seconds to go. 12-point game. Connor Thornton. The clock ticks below 10. Kucevic, 5 seconds to go. Kucevic backs up and takes a deep three. Doesn't make it. Not a great finish to the half for Setanta, but they'll be pleased as we go in the end of the third quarter. It's Colosta Pobl, Setanta 44, Piper's Hill 32. So here we go, start of the fourth quarter, the under 16B boys schools league final. It's Scolosta Pobl Setanta leading by 12, make that 10 as Alex Duo gets the first basket of the fourth quarter. And Connor, it was close early, second half being dominated by Setanta, but what can Pipers Hill do to try and get themselves back in this game and turn it around?
Like you spoke, they just have to do what's working for them, that's getting the ball. Juro's had a lot of luck inside, and he's one of the smallest guys on the court. You know, he's just being a bit crafty, and they've maybe scored one or two three-pointers the whole game, and that's not going to cut it from here on out. They just got to have a diverse way of scoring, and if they keep taking the three-pointers, it's not going to work. But if they can get inside, all rebound, they'll have a good chance of, as they've shown already, scoring the ball, but it's all going to come down from defense. Can they stop them getting the ball inside to Sammy? Can they put pressure on the ball, and can they get out in the break to get some easy scores?
So the noise picks up here in the packed arena as Jimmy Rotary picks up a foul. Connor Thornton, buoyed by the extra noise here, claps hands on defense. Maguire finds that man Duro. Good rebound from Kelly. Give himself another chance. Can't get it, and Pajani just tips it to himself. And they'll need to stop him. They don't. And Jack Maguire calling for looking for the charge, but definitely turned his back on the ball.
Yeah, might feel it was an offensive foul, but it was definitely a smart foul by Maguire. Something they didn't do in the first half was stop them when they're on the break and have numbers. And good foul there. Get a chance to set up your defense.
So a 10-point game. Next basket or two going to be crucial here for Gianni. Thornton, open three from the top of the key. And that's huge for Connor Thornton.
It just looks like Clash Pulse Italian have too many ways of scoring right now, whereas Pipers Hill are a bit limited in what they can do.
And Rotary gets it back to Fajani. This time he does charge. And good defense inside from Kelly.
Yeah, Kelly did well there. Stood his ground, and Fajani just dropped his shoulder and gave away the charge. And that's the sort of defense they're going to need. They're going to need stops. They haven't had too many stops in the second half so far. Get stops and try and get some easy scores inside on this side of the play.
Kane inside to Kelly. Kelly tries to get Fajani off his feet. He does! And he makes the two off the glass, and back-to-back fouls for Fajani, but only his second of the game.
But Kelly's another who's had some good luck in the paint as well. Great job using his pump fake again. Get the ball nice and high. Got lucky to get the shot away, and thankfully it fell down for them. If they can push on from here now and make it a game, you don't know what... This is close to the talents to lose. As far as it is now, Pipers Hill have nothing to lose, so they've just got to go for it.
The bad news for Pipers Hill, apart from the fact that Rotary's just nailed another two, is that Jack Maguire is limping below to the calf. Hopefully it's just a little bit of cramp. So we have a timeout here, 5:47 to go. It's a 13-point lead for Colossal Pobl Setanta. So 5:40 to go. Alex Duo tries to find a bit of space. Kelly for two, doesn't go. And Jack Maguire's calf obviously worse than it looked, as he's had to sit down, might be getting a bit of treatment from the physio. And again, the strength of Fajani gets fouled and will go to the line for one more.
Yeah, he just got the ball a bit too easy. He was able to take it at the rim, missed the first, too big, got his own rebound, and just showed a strength to go up over the arms of a couple of defenders and able to finish the ball as well.
He can't make the free throw, and it's well kept in. And Kelly gets it to Duo, who's now one of the point guard. Duo goes straight to the basket, and lucky there, bounces out. But those need to go in at this point as they trail by 15 with just under 5 to go. Timog, long three, in and out, but good rebound. And score from Adelani.
Just seems he's slipping away from Piper's Hill now. Without Maguire on the floor, there's not much direction.
Kelly does his bit, as he has done for most of the second half, with another basket. Oh, unlucky defense, but the foul does go on 10. Fernando Duo, as he puts his hand in, and we'll have a couple of subs here. Into the game for the first time will come George Jakob. As Sami Fajani takes a break, along with Jimmy Rotary. Kelly gets the ball, but fumbles. And he's unfortunately called for a travel here. Connor, we see a lot of subs coming in for Setanta. Is it early in the game, or do they think they've got this one sewn up?
I think they have it sewn up at this stage. I mean, they've shown that, you know, while Sami might have had, you know, around 30 points, they've all shown a way that they can score. Right on cue.
Exactly that. Richard Gregoris shows that he can more than pick up the slack as he extends the lead here. Duo finds a bit of space down the lane. Beautiful drive from Duo. He's had a fantastic game for himself.
Yeah, it was that he cradled the ball really well there. Protected it from the defenders, and a nice hook shot finish.
Timog looking to find a bit of space. Kelly on the break, nice hands from Kelly. Doesn't get the call, and it ends up in the hands of Kevin Shea. But hands, good steal from Duo, and this time Duo is fouled, and he'll go to the line for two.
Yeah, another strong take from Duo, protecting the ball and keeping it out in his right hand, and foul call. And if you can knock down these two shots now, it's maybe just a little chance.
Don't forget, plenty more of the school's finals to come. Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, all live on the YouTube basketball and YouTube channel. 12 o'clock today is Cross and Passion Kilcullen versus Skolmuir Cork. And it's under 16 B girls, and it's under 16 C boys. Kloshenuk Corrie versus St Mary's Marist Dundalk, and then 3 o'clock is the under 16 C girls, Castlereagh versus St Catherine's Killybegs. So the defence chance pick up here as Piper's Hill sniff one last chance. Timog goes up, rebound to Kelly, he's people in front of him, but he can't get hold of the ball. He does eventually, and Kane gets it forward to Duro, who's been the scoring threat in the second half, but can't make that one, and good rebound. But as it's Fernando Duro that tries to get a steal. And we'll have a timeout here with 2:36 to go. It's 53-41. So 2:36 to go, full court pressure from Piper's Hill.
You see Maguire's after checking back into the game. Maybe they still think it's there.
And the new man, Aiden Hall, goes all the way to the basket for Satanta, and he is fouled. First one bounced out for Hall. Good rebound from Kevin Shea. Gives them another chance, and something Piper's Hill just can't afford at this stage. They need the ball in their hands. Timog, long two as he puts his foot on the line. And Kevin Shea slows things down. He finds Timog. Fadeaway jumper, and the one thing you can say about Timog is he doesn't lack confidence.
No, Clashwell's trying to give him three or four chances to score that offense. You know, when you're trying to win a game, you got to make sure you get your rebounds.
And Timog breaks the pressure. Joe goes to steal, doesn't get it. Timog to Adelani, takes a long two, doesn't get it again. Offensive rebounds are just hurting Piper's Hill at the moment, as Adelani finishes with a two.
Yeah, like you mentioned, another offensive rebound, and they scored off the rebound.
Maguire bounces out, and here comes Hall. Inside goes to Adiob, doesn't make it. Good hands from Timog. Rebound by Kelly with 1:10 to go. And Connor, we can see here over the last few minutes since Fajani went out, it hasn't really made much difference to Tanda. They've been able to sustain it with their bench players as well.
Yeah, they've obviously got a couple of guys who, like you said, don't lack confidence. No problem shooting the ball. And when you don't, when you have that confidence in your own ability to score the ball, you know, it reflects, you know, in a game like this. You know, they're 10 points up, push it out to 14, and it's been a superb all-round performance from Crossfields Tampa.
So, a minute to go. Maguire can't get his three off, gets it to Kelly. And Kelly with a float that doesn't go, but rebounded inside from Kane, who can't finish. And a foul called on Adelani, and it will be two shots. So stay with us after the game for the presentations. We will be turning the sound off for contractual reasons with the music, but you can stay and watch the presentations with us, and then we'll be back for staying live for the 12 o'clock game. As Piper's Hill run their bench, so into the game comes Josh Dunn. Dara Confrey, Maha Rodriguez, and Morafi Owami is my best guess. Sorry, Owami, if I got that, or Morafi, if I got that wrong. We'll stop now before I make it worse for him. So Jack Hogan at the line. Hogan can't make the second. And we'll have a sub here. So it will be, checking in the first time is Adam Kane. So 47 seconds to go. Ross Maher gets the basket, but it ends up in the hands of Josh Dunn, but good pressure from Kucevic. And Kucevic can't find O'Shea. So 26 seconds to go. Connor, Kolostopoulos Atanta, best teams throughout the game, but talk to us quickly, who will be the MVP for this game?
I don't think it'll come as any surprise to anybody. MVP is going to be the 14 from Kolostopoulos Atanta, Sami Fajana. Not only has he been exceptional on the scoreboard, he's put up a lot of points, but he's altered a lot of shots, he's blocked a lot of shots, and he's secured almost every rebound that's come his way. He's done a really fantastic all-round performance, and he really carried his team through today.
And Coach Slajan Kucevic does put his starting five back on the floor for the last few seconds, just so they get to celebrate the win as they storm the court. So in the first of the schools league finals, the under-16B boys final goes to Kolostopoulos Atanta, who have beaten Pipers Hill from Nice on a scoreline of 57-43. Stay with us for the 12 o'clock game. We're back with you shortly.